Everybody wanna wiggle. One, two, three, go. Wah, 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 wah.
'Cause what this is Nicole, that's the Cully Bear, the Sassmeister, the man behind the camera. We're coming at you with a brand new video, 9 reasons why you're not losing weight. Let's do this.
I'm scared.
Number one, you are not weighing and measuring your food. A lot of people, when they want to get healthy and lose weight, they automatically start eating healthier foods. But what they do is they're still scooping their food on the plate, or they're grabbing a handful of healthy snacks, or they're just throwing a granola bar and lots of fruit into their lunch pail, and they're not keeping track of how much they're eating. If you're not weighing or portioning out your food, you're probably going to end up eating more than you expected, and that will cause you to either gain weight or stay still and not lose it, not continue getting results. So weigh your food with a scale or portion it out with measuring cups and spoons. How you portion it is by looking at the sizes, the serving sizes on the backs of nutrition labels. It's exactly what Kyle and I did to lose weight. We bought a scale, measuring cups and spoons, and we started portioning everything out. Two, you're overeating healthy food. So this goes with number one. A lot of people will say, okay, I'm eating healthy now. I'm gonna eat a salad. And what they do is they have a salad and it's lovely, but then they dump a bottle of dressing on it. Again, you're not measuring and you're eating way too much. You're throwing nuts in your salad. You're throwing croutons in there. You're throwing cheese in there. And what was healthy is now a giant bowl full of calories. Or you're like, nuts are healthy, fruit's healthy, and you're eating way too much. You're eating from the bag, don't even realize how much fat you're taking in. You're eating bags of grapes, or you know, you go through a banana and an apple and an orange and
airplanes.
And by the time you know it, you've taken in a ton of carbs and sugar and fat in the form of fruit or nuts or whatever. Healthy is great. Healthy, eating healthy helps you lose weight. However, you still need to be aware of how much healthy food you're eating, because too much of any food is gonna make you gain weight or not get results and stay the same. Three, you're mindlessly snacking. So you're losing weight, you're eating healthy, you're measuring your food, but then you're not having pre-prepped snacks. So you're just grabbing granola bar, grabbing a handful of nuts, grabbing healthy cereal, yogurt, and you're just eating from the tub. You're not portioning out your snacks. You still need to be aware of what you're eating. You need to have snacks portioned. When Kyle and I were losing weight, we had all of our snacks portioned and labeled with our name and the day. That way we knew after all of Monday's snacks are gone, on Monday, you don't grab any more. That helped us from mindlessly snacking, because once our pre-portioned snacks were done, we didn't grab for anything else. So having snacks ready to go each day will stop you from overeating. Four, you're not drinking enough water. If you aren't hydrated, your body may send you signs that you're hungry when actually you're thirsty. You're not hydrated enough. So making sure that you're drinking enough water, at least 8 8-ounce glasses of water a day, you're gonna get more results by getting your water in. The other thing is, being hydrated helps you with being regular. It helps you regulate all the levels in your body, and it helps you feel full, especially if you drink water with your meals. It will help you from overeating.
While you're dieting too, you are gonna be eating a lot less food, and so you want your body to be able to absorb the most nutrients from that food. Water really helps with digestion.
It does, it helps with digestion, it helps with fullness, So you really want to make sure that you get your water in. That's really important. If you're not hydrated enough, you're not going to get the best results. 5. You're under-eating during the day and overeating at night. A lot of people will skip meals or be running late and go, oh, I'll just eat later. What happens when you're not eating enough during the day, at night you're gonna be so hungry. Even if you have everything measured in portion, you're gonna end up grabbing more because you didn't feed yourself enough throughout the day. Eating consistently and making sure that you're getting enough food will help prevent you from the overeating at night, especially because night seems to be a lot of people's issue where they tend to reach for food more. So by eating regularly, portioning your food, having stuff prepared and on hand, that will all prevent you from reaching for more food and overeating, and that will really help you get the results you're looking for.
We were classic like late night overeaters.
Yes.
The whole entire time that we were big for like decades.
And we skipped meals. And that made us, well, that helped us overeat at night.
One of the number one signs that your metabolism is broken and that you're overeating just in general, or that you have a lot of weight to lose or a lot of body fat, is you're not hungry in the morning. So you need to fix that by eating in the morning, get your body moving, all the tips we're giving you here.
Exactly, yeah. You want to be hungry. If you're not hungry, your metabolism isn't working. And that is another reason, bonus, why you're not losing weight. You gotta get that metabolism working. You gotta get that hunger up.
And we only know this because me and Nicole, well, especially me, I think I used that excuse for years. I'm not hungry in the morning. Well, I was hungry at night and packing on weight too.
I used it when I was bigger. I would say, oh, I'm not hungry, I'm not gonna eat breakfast, because that allowed me to eat anything I wanted. That allowed me to eat whole bags of chips later at night because I allowed that. Oh, you didn't eat breakfast? Well, you can eat this bag of chips because you're really hungry, so it's okay.
It's like a massive success barrier where you're basically lying to yourself and tricking yourself and setting yourself up for failure.
Exactly. Number 6. This is a big one that people don't even think about. You're drinking your calories. A lot of people, when they start trying to lose weight, they'll go to smoothies, meal replacements, protein shakes. They'll drink coffee and tea, but they'll add stuff to it like cream and sugar and milk. Not even realizing drinking all those things without being aware of what you're putting in is gonna prevent you from getting results. Smoothies are healthy, green tea is healthy. However, if you're throwing stuff into your smoothie without even being aware of what you're having, you're probably consuming way more carbs, sugar, and fat than you bargained for. And that's like a hidden thing why you're not losing weight.
This is why we harp on the drinking calories so much, because so many of you guys in the comments are telling us that you're cleaning up your diet, you're seeing results, and then you're adding honey to your tea because it's a natural sugar, but like it's totally throwing your weight loss off.
Honey may be a natural sugar, but it still has sugar. Those are things that affect Kyle and myself. It affects our bodies a lot. Natural sugar from fruit, from honey, from pure maple syrup, that's still sugar for our bodies. Our bodies hold on to weight with natural or processed sugar.
Yeah, when you're adding, like let's say you add honey to your tea, that's not gonna keep you full when you're dieting. So that's one of why it becomes a major problem when you're drinking, you're hungry because you're dieting. So you start adding calories to your tea or whatever, you're drinking smoothies. You're still gonna be hungry after those. It doesn't fill you up. It's not real food, but it's calories.
Exactly, and that's the thing. Like a lot of people will go to smoothies to get all their fruits and veggies in. However, personally for me, I find if I drink a smoothie, or I used to try meal replacements, I don't anymore because it's not the same as food. For myself, I can drink a smoothie or a meal replacement and I'm starving 5 minutes later. So I drank all of those calories and I'm still hungry. So now I'm eating real food or solid food, and all those calories that I drank are adding up because I still have to eat food to get myself to feel full. So for us, we prefer to eat the food, not drink the calories. We prefer to save the calories for the food so that we can still be in a deficit and lose weight.
So when that's what we do when we're kind of analyzing what you guys are telling us and trying to help you, mm-hmm. when you say, I'm really hungry, I'm portioning my food, but how do you deal with the hunger? Then we find out, like,
you're having smoothies,
you're having honey in your tea, you're putting sugar in your coffee still, and you're saying, I'm not losing weight, but I'm hungry. Well, they're some of the hidden things.
Yeah, or I'm not losing weight and I don't know what it is, but you're not drinking your coffee and tea black. Or, you know, you're throwing full fat or flavored yogurt into your smoothie and not realizing that that has extra carbs, sugar. So just being aware of what you're putting in the form of liquid, because those calories, sugar, carbs, those add up very fast.
And you have to pick your battles. Like, you can use a sweetener for your coffee if you need it,
sure.
if you need it sweet or whatever. But then the next excuse they'll go to is, I don't like artificial sweeteners. Well, make your choice. Do you want to keep going on your weight loss journey, or do you want to have just a little bit of artificial sweetener?
Yeah, so that is, pick your battles. Doing these small changes that you might not realize, these will help you get your results. Number 7, you're not working hard enough. In order to lose weight and get results, Kyle and I have had to be in a deficit. You're gonna be hungry. A lot of people say, I'm hungry. It's normal to be a little hungry because you're in a deficit. Number 2, you have to work hard. We've learned in the beginning, you know, doing a small walk when we were almost 300 and almost 400 pounds was a lot of work for us. Now we've had to up the intensity because we're smaller and in better shape, so we have to up the intensity. You have to keep working harder as you get more fit, because your body gets used to it.
Gets more stubborn.
So you need to give it. When you're doing cardio, you should be breathing heavy, sweating like crazy, and barely able to hold a conversation. That should be the intensity. When you're in the gym, you should be working with so much intensity that you don't care about anyone else around you. You should be focused on getting your workout done, burning with your muscles, feeling like, oh my gosh, I don't think I can do this. That's the intensity you need. If you're not doing that, that's probably why you're not seeing results.
And if you have time and energy to keep checking your phone every 5 seconds,
you're
not doing an intense workout.
No, we see a lot of people standing around in between sets on their cell phones. Kyle and I are drinking water, catching our breath, amping ourselves up for the next set.
If you're not a little fearful of the next set, going into the next set, whether or not you're gonna make it or not, then
you're not working hard enough.
Yeah.
So amp it up, buttercup. 8, and Kyle and I are still working on this one. You're not getting enough sleep or the greatest quality of sleep. Sleep is really important, because if you're stressed out and you're not sleeping enough, you're gonna have higher levels of cortisol. Higher levels of cortisol mean your body is holding on to belly fat. So you really wanna work on the stress level, and you wanna work on sleeping. You might be somebody who only has, you know, time to get 6 hours of sleep a night, but if you make them the best quality 6 hours, that's gonna make a huge difference.
Yeah, that's a big thing me and Nicole have been discussing lately. Like, okay, we're really busy, we might not get 8 to 12 hours of sleep, but let's say we get 5 quality, that's way better than tossing and turning for 8 hours, right?
Yes. And really, with our schedules, I probably get 5 hours of sleep per night, but because I'm working on my anxiety and I know how important it is for my results, my 5 hours are pretty quality, solid hours of sleep, which is why I can go and outwork someone else in the gym who's had 8, but they weren't the greatest quality. And the last one, baby, number 9. You're copying other people's diets.
Including ours.
We often see a lot of people going, oh, I don't know how you guys do this. I'm trying to do it and I can't lose weight. Or you guys eat way too many carbs for me. Or we do videos, yes, to help you, but keep in mind, we're not doctors, we're not dietitians, we've never claimed to be. This is our diet. We share with you what has worked for us in the past and what works for us now.
We want you guys to cherry pick our diet.
Yes.
Like, pick out the best parts that work awesome for you and take that and run with it.
Yes, but we're not saying do everything that we say. We've never said ever copy exactly what we're doing, because you might not have the same body type. If you're copying, you know, a fitness person's diet and exercise plan from, you know, online, you might not have the same genetics. You might not have the same body type, the same goals, the same work routine, or you might be, you know, you might have to work really hard in your job where someone else is really sedentary and you're copying their diet. If you don't modify things for you and do what works best for you, you're not gonna get results because you're copying a plan that works well for someone else. What we do works really good for us, which is why we show it in hopes to inspire you to find what works for you and to give you ideas to try that might help you. But we're not saying copy or do exactly as we do because we have different bodies and lifestyles than you do.
Yeah, like you might be able to copy someone, it'll work for a little bit, but then your differences in genetics, lifestyle, all that will come into play and then it won't work anymore. Then you're gonna have to find out what works for you eventually anyways.
Yeah, so don't copy something exactly. Like Kyle said, cherry pick the best things that you think could work for you and try them out. And if they don't work, try something else. That will help you get the results and stop you from wondering, why am I not losing weight? Check out these 9 things. One of them might be a reason why you're not losing weight or why you're not getting the results you want.
We actually want you guys to succeed. So
we
if we were lying to you, we would just say, it's so easy, just copy us.
Yeah, just do what we do.
But we don't want to lie to you. We want you to actually have long-term success, which a lot of people in social media seem to forget. Like, it's about sustainability. How long can you do this and how successful it is over time, not first week, not first couple days.
And you know, there's another thing that Kyle said, like, it might work for you for a short amount of time. Everything works for a short amount of time, but then, like we mentioned earlier, your body gets used to things. So you might have been able to drink your calories before, but now you've hit a plateau and you're not losing weight anymore. Now you've got to change that. So being mindful of all of these things may help you cut through or break through that plateau. We always need to change. There's not one perfect diet, one perfect exercise plan for everyone. Some people can eat more than others. Some people can work less, not as hard as others.
Me and Nicole weren't born with perfect genetics.
We have to work very difficult. We have to work very hard to get just a little bit of results.
If we were born with like perfect genetics, we could tell you to eat like cantaloupe and do hula hooping and people would listen to us, but that's not the case.
No. All right, the friends, so we really want you to be successful. We love you, we care about you, and we've been through all of these things. We've hit plateaus, we've wondered why we weren't losing weight. We've done all these 9 things. So we're trying to prevent you from making the same mistakes that we did. We love you, we hope you enjoyed this video and are inspired to make things work for you, and have a lovely day. Wait, don't do that yet. And don't forget, hit the bell for notifications so that you can see every single video. Don't forget to check us out on Instagram, at The Colettes. If you want some fancy, cool, fight fruit gear, check out the link down below.
Yeah, we even got long sleeves, hoodies for the cold winter days.
Cool. Yeah. We also have 2 weight loss guides. You can check out the links down below for those if you'd like those. Don't forget, like this video. We want lots of people to see it. We want to help lots of people. So the more you like it, the more people that we can help. As a team, as a community, we can help people. So like it up, buttercup. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't, because then you'll be cool. We love you guys. Have a lovely day. Thank you so much for watching and for your support. That's it for now. Peace out. Colettes out, dudes. There's no counter, so I did that.
You can't hide behind the counter out here. I can see everything.
Bye, guys. Thanks for watching.
See ya.
Remember, the friends, that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here. Heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up.